The small and medium-sized enterprise sector contribute up to 60% of employment in the country, though it still has a lot of unexploited potential. This is according to Industrialization Principal Secretary Dr. Wilson Songa, who says that the sector needs to produce goods that meet international standards to be more competitive. To achieve this, the ministry is urging SMEs to liaise with the Micro and Small Enterprises Authority when developing their products to attain these standards and benefit from identified marketing opportunities.
Emphasize the need for standards, and that is why our standards institutions will have to work very closely with them so that they can guide them along. Because when we are talking about marketing, we are talking about standards.
To further grow the sector, East African countries are drafting harmonized regulation for SMEs in the EAC region that aims at addressing, among others, legal and taxation issues affecting free cross-border trade.
A harmonized proposal, which is then going to be discussed at the EAC and come up with a one harmonized approach to SME development for the EAC.
Songa says the Enterprise Authority has identified classes of investment where the country has natural competitive advantage, such as leather, textiles, clothing, agro-processing, furniture and circles. He urged the SMEs to liaise with the authority to benefit from such investment opportunities.
It has identified clusters whom they can comprehensively address based on certain skills. If it is a leather cluster, then they will go for skills that would address the leather industry. If it is metal fabrication, they will go for that. If it is furniture, they will go for the skills that would promote development of furniture that would be competitive in the region.
Among the challenges currently facing SMEs are unfavorable policy environment, inhibitive legal and regulatory environment, and limited access to financial services. Nicholas Nduati, Business Insights.